Greetings, travelers. It is I, SundaeOfDoom, here to wreak havoc upon all the uninformed. So, CitizenCon 2017 or CitizenCon 2947 happened, and it was really good. Normally, they have presentations that are around 2 to 3 hours, and it's mostly a demo at the end, and it's kind of like, oh, okay, it's nice. This case, they decided to go for the full shebang and go for a 7.5 to 8 hour conference or convention, where for most of that it was panels with the developers, and they're showing off little bits of what they have that's pretty amazing in itself. And I even remember Board Gamer UK, another YouTuber, and he also does Twitch and stuff, mostly YouTube though. He went to one of the CIG studios, and he was talking to one of the developers, and the developer was like, that's how much stuff we could show in 7.5 to 8 hours worth of time that we are allotted. We have so much more, and they showed off a bit of it to him, but they have like so much more that they wanted to show, but they just didn't have enough time to do it. It restored a lot of my faith and I love the nitty gritty. I love learning about, like, they showed one of the panels was all about the Xi'an language and how they came up with it, and like how you too, like, they made a document for us to be able to learn how to speak Xi'an, which is, I love. Like, I've always wanted to learn Klingon, but I didn't feel the drive for it as much. But in this case, this is literally in the game, and if I learn it, I can maybe speak something that other people can't understand, and then it screws with them, so I can kind of maybe put a secret code in to, or say something secretly to someone else, or I can understand what a NPC is saying before like a little translator pops up. That's if they even have translators, I don't know. I just love that nitty gritty kind of stuff. They also brought out the Consolidated Outland Pioneer, which is what they've been calling the Game Changer, and it pretty much is. Like, normally in the game, when you do trading and mining, or when you mine and you sell it to on the market or the local market in that system, or you go to another system to sell it on a better market, then a NPC picks that up and sends it to whatever NPC manufacturing plant requires it. Now we have something that players can use those minerals for to manufacture themselves, and what the Pioneer does is it manufactures habitats. So when you say you find a planet that's, you know, very like it's a new planet, no one's around in it, you could land on it, claim a part of the land, and start building up on there. And the Pioneer, the ship will actually open up and start to fabricate habitats. It even has an architecture or architect station where the architect or whoever is designing it can like put whatever modules you need for on that, and then after it's done, it places it down underneath it. And it's pretty amazing. That's a hell of a game changer, because that means we can have guild or org housing or org production. Or just personal housing. You could have a nice little farmstead somewhere if you wanted to. And quite a few stations that you can build with this, like medical stations, which is what they're thinking you'll be able to spawn at, or people can spawn at it for a fee if they're nearby, if they die, or something happens to them. Or the science station, where basically, if you have, like, say, a weird anomaly near you, or, like, the sun is an odd sun, you can study it and then sell that information. Farming, drug labs, mining, and there's a couple other ones I can't remember exactly. But it's just, it's pretty awesome to be able to do that. Also, there is a sort of a deal going on right now where if you buy one of the $45... game packages, which is the package that only sells Star Citizen, and you put in a coupon code called New Beginnings. That's all one word. I'll put it in the description. New Beginnings, all one word. In the kind of coupon, like you press the coupon button when you're in the what do you call it, the checkouts screen, and you'll get $5 off of that package. It kind of sucks because I'm surprised they don't put that on the $60 package, which includes Squadron 42. But yeah, but if you actually do want to get a hold of Star Citizen, and you don't really care about the Squadron 42 single player campaign, then this might be a pretty good deal for you. It's basically $40 instead of $45. And I believe they said they're going to give you the ability to add the Squadron 42 for $15 afterwards. I'm not too sure because they said that many months ago, so it's taking quite a long time. So if you're new to Star Citizen and you click Fly Now when you get on the Robert Space Industries page, you choose one of these. I would say choose the Aurora because the Aurora just got its new redesign and it looks really good. Like, it really looks really good. Mustang is okay, but it's kind of it's a very flimsy but fast fighter. So this isn't too slow, but it's mostly supposed to be like a tanky trading ship. So you just select that. I would say add this, but you can't because yeah, it says add for $15 more, but you can't get the $5 off for some reason with this. So you get that, and then you say create an account if you're new to this. Put in your handle, login. Login is your you should have your login as a different thing from your handle, because that way it makes it harder for people to hack. So the handle is your permanent, it's going to be your permanent name, and also URL. It creates a URL for your profile, and then the community moniker is one that you can actually change at any time. So yeah, and then if you want to get 5,000 extra UEC, which is about $5 worth, at least as of now, you can put in a referral code like mine. Just what you do is you select it, copy and paste. Mine is star-6xvm-2gzr, or you can use someone else's, like your friends. Then you just fill everything out and then enlist now, and you're basically good to go. It'll send you to the store page. I can't show you because if I do, you'll end up seeing my address and stuff like that. But it will send you to the store page, and you just keep fill in your billing address, and then you'll get to the cart, and in the cart you'll see the $45 game package, and then at the bottom there's like a coupon or a credit. It's called credit/coupon or something like that. You click on it, and then you fill in New Beginnings. That's all one word. I'll put that in the description, and I'll also put my referral in the description so it's easier to do. But yeah, and after then you just hit apply, and then you get $5 off. So it might be a good time to go for it now, especially with this $5 off thing, especially with how 3.0 might be coming out. I don't know about some people say it might be coming out in November, and it seems pretty close. A lot of the Evocatis have, or at least there's been a lot of leaks, and it seems like it's getting closer and closer to the actual time for it to be released. And yeah, I'm pretty excited to download it myself. It's gonna be, they're gonna have trading. They won't have mining, I believe. At least not at this time. But they did say they'll have hauling and trading in 3.0. 3.1, they're going to be putting the mining into the actual game, I believe. But it'll have trading, it'll have hauling, trading, and mercenary work for 3.0. And there's supposed to be quite a lot of quests or missions for you to do. And also it'll have three planets for you to, or three moons, and I believe a planet for you to be able to just explore, because they're pretty massive in itself. Just being able to do that, because back when I was in the Kickstarter, I didn't even think we were going to have that. We were just basically going to have little landing zones, and they would have like little corridors so that it would automatically send you down to it. Now you have like a massive planet that you can actually just fly over. Even in the demo that they showed after all those panels, they showed going all the way, like all across a planet full of buildings. It's just, and not all those buildings are going to be enterable, but it's just, I don't know, it's just pretty amazing, and it screams Blade Runner to me. Anyways, I hope that was informative enough, and yeah, later days.